गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन। स्टूडेंट्स, एक्चुअली इफ वी सी द ग्लोबलाइजेशन मूव्स अराउंड द इकोनॉमी। वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द फोर फ्लोज व्हेन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन। फोर फ्लोज, द फ्लो ऑफ कमोडिटी, द फ्लो ऑफ पीपल, कैपिटल एंड आइडियाज। बट एक्चुअली इफ वी से दिस ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द इकोनॉमी ओनली, बिकॉज ऑफ इकोनॉमी द पीपल ऑफ वन कंट्री गो टू अनदर कंट्री टू गेट जॉब। बिकॉज ऑफ इकोनॉमी द थिंग्स, द कमोडिटीज आर परचेज्ड एंड सोल्ड, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द इकोनॉमी द मनी इज ऑल्सो फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर कंट्री। सो इफ वी सी दैट ऑल दीज फ्लोज इन ग्लोबलाइजेशन आर बिकॉज ऑफ इकोनॉमी, देन इट विल नॉट बी अ फॉल्स, इट इज ट्रू। बिकॉज ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक इन ग्लोबलाइजेशन, इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस लाइक इंटरनेशनल मोनेट्री फंड, WTO, दिस वी हैव स्टडीड इन लेसन नंबर 6 इन इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, IMF, WTO एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक, दे प्ले एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन डिटर्मिंग द इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड। दिस इज द फर्स्ट इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सिक्वेंसी दैट इंटरनेशनल इकोनॉमिक इंस्टीट्यूशंस, इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंटरनेशनल मोनेट्री फंड, वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक, दे प्ले एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन डिटर्मिनिंग द इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। वन मोर कॉन्सिक्वेंसी, greater trade in commodities across the world, as we have seen in the example of that father who has purchased a cycle made in China and who has purchased a doll for his daughter, that doll was made in USA. It means now the things of one country are available in any part of the world. So trade has increased. Things which are produced in one part of the world can be available in any part of the world. Now the people are having many choices. Suppose you want to purchase a phone and you go in the market. Now you are having not 1000 but more than 50 or 60 types of mobile phones are available in the market. You are having so many choices. This is why? This is because of globalization. The phones made in other countries are available in India. So this is also an economic consequences. Now the people are having more choices. More choices are there. You want to purchase a shirt. You want to purchase a shoe. Then many brands are available in the market. So there are so many choices. One more important economic consequence of globalization is that restriction on import have been relaxed by different countries. Earlier, what was there in India? India was having more public sector and less private sector, and India has banned for import because of the protectionism that I will discuss in the next topic of this chapter. But due to this globalization, the restriction upon import has been relaxed by different countries. For example, India has relaxed these restrictions in 1991 when India has adopted LPG. LPG means liberalization, privatization and globalization. So students, this economic consequences, these are very important part. Spread of internet has also fastened this process. Now developed countries, they have put the restriction on visa policies to protect the job security of their citizens. Students, you must know this thing, that the people of poor country, they are going to rich countries for job, and they are getting job there. For example, many people from India, they are going to USA, but now the people of USA, they are not getting job, so the developed countries, they are putting restrictions of visas. One more thing in economy, the multinational companies do not belong to poor countries. Multinational companies are from rich countries. They are from developed countries, and they are going to poor countries. They are getting more and more profits in these poor countries. So, this economic consequences of globalization is that globalization is more beneficial to developed countries, not developing countries. Because when the multinational companies of developed countries, they go in developing countries, they earn a huge amount of profit, and this enrich their own developed country. So these developed countries, they are sending multinational companies, and when they see that more people are coming in their country for job, they put restriction, because they want to give jobs to their own citizens. It means, in the world, if we see, the economic effect of globalization is not same in all parts of the world. It is beneficial for rich countries. It is beneficial for developed countries, but it is not beneficial for poor countries. Its negative impact is that it has created a division of the world. One part of the world has become rich and another part of the world has become poor. Many countries have become poor and some countries, they have become rich. And poor countries, they are having large population. They are not able to spend on the education, on health, on sanitation. Only in developing countries, if we say, only some people are getting benefits of globalization. So, students, those people who are in favor of economic globalization, they say that globalization generates economic growth of a country, economic growth of the people living in that country, and it also works for the well-being of larger section of the population. If there will be more trade, then more job opportunities will be there. The people will get more benefit, and this will be beneficial for the world. But the coin has two sides. If we see the economic consequences of globalization, then we can say that this globalization has divided the world into rich and poor. This is a type of recolonization. Earlier, there was colonization. India was the colony of Britain, as many of the countries of Africa and Asia, these were the colonies of European countries. That was known as colonization. Now we can say this is again the recolonization. The rich countries, they are controlling the economy of poor countries. It is harmful for weak countries, it is harmful for poor people also. Supporters argument I have already told you, that economic growth and well-being of the larger section. So students, these were the economic effect, economic consequences, economic impact of globalization. Tomorrow we will discuss about the cultural impact of globalization. Goodbye.